A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Bibi Sakina is the daughter of Imam Hussain, our third Imam. Imam Hussain was the son of Imam Ali, our first Imam, and Bibi Fatima, the only daughter of Prophet Muhammad. Her mother, Umm Rubab, was the daughter of the chief of the tribe of Kinda. Other names that Bibi Sakina alayhi salam is known by are Sakina and Ruqayya. Bibi Sakina was born on the 1st of Rajab in Medina in 57 AH. Imam Hussain felt very happy and used to compare her to his mother, Fatima Zahra. Like her grandmother, she is a Mazluma, an oppressed, and a Shahida, the martyr. The Holy Prophet Muhammad used to call Bibi Fatima Bazzatun Minni, a part of me. Bibi Sakina is a part of Imam Hussain alayhi salam, the leader of the youth of paradise. Just as Bibi Fatima had to suffer hardship after the death of her father, Bibi Sakina alayhi salam, the beloved daughter of Imam Hussain, faced many trials after Imam Hussain's shahadat in Karbala. Even though she was so young, she was very patient in the face of suffering and hardship. She was a Hafiz of Quran at 4 years old, which shows how intelligent and clever Bibi Sakina was. She had a baby brother called Ali Asghar, who was born on 15 Rajab 60 AH. Their mother, Hazrat Umm Rubab, loved both her children very much and took great care of her two children. Both of them helped their father, Imam Hussain alayhi salam, in saving Islam. Bibi Sakina gave up her life in the love of her father. She was taken as a captive from city to city and died a martyr in the prison of Damascus, far away from her home. Her death made people aware of how cruel Yazid was and made them think about the message of Islam given by Imam Hussain. We must follow his example and uphold the truth, even if we had to face difficulties. When Imam Hussain and all their family, including the 4-year-old Bibi Sakina, arrived in Karbala on the 2nd of Muharram, 61 AH, she saw her uncle Abbas put up their tents by the riverbank. Her father called the owners of the land and bought it. Bibi Sakina heard a roar as hundreds of soldiers marched into Karbala. They forced the Imam to move from the riverbank and set up their tents away from the river. More and more Yazidi soldiers came to fight against the Imam. Soon they blocked the riverbank and said no water would be allowed for the Imam and his family. By the 7th of Muharram, all the water that was there with the Imam had run out. All the children and Bibi Sakina were very thirsty and cried, "Alatash, Alatash, we're thirsty, we're thirsty." They went from one tent to another to ask if anyone had any water for them. There was no water left. The river flowed nearby, but the children of Imam Hussain were thirsty. Some of the friends of Imam Hussain tried to get water for the children. Hazrat Abbas alayhi salam and some other young men dug a well, but no water was found. The day of Ashur, 10 Muharram, was the saddest day of Bibi Sakina's life. It was a day when all her family was killed. She saw all her uncles, cousins, and brothers die one after another. She heard how all her father's friends like Habib and Zuhair were killed. Bibi Sakina saw her aunt Zainab say goodbye to her two sons, Aunt and Muhammad. She saw her aunt Umm Farwa weep when her son Hazrat Qasim's body was brought back, trampled by horses. She tugged at her brother Ali Akbar's cloak as everyone cried when he was leaving the camp. By the middle of the afternoon, there was no one left except her father, Imam Hussain. Bibi Sakina alayhi salam was very sad. Now it was her father, her dear father, who was going. Imam Hussain hugged his 4-year-old daughter and said, "My last salams on you, Sakina." "Don't go, father," she sobbed. "Can't we go back to Medina?" "No, we can't, my dear. The roads are blocked. No one can enter or leave Karbala now." The Imam then went to see his son, Ali Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam, who lay ill with fever. He said goodbye to all the Bibis, who made a circle, and asked the Imam to pass through it. He stepped outside and found his horse waiting. The Imam looked to the right and to the left. There was no one now to help him mount. Where are you, Akbar? Where are you, Abbas? Where are you, Habib and Zuhair? Will no one help me to mount my horse? The horse stopped. I know you are tired and thirsty, but this is my last ride. Let's go, he said kindly to the horse. The horse wouldn't move and hung down his head. The Imam saw that his daughter Sakina was clinging to the horse and crying, Don't take away my father, please. The Imam jumped down from his horse and lifted Bibi Sakina in his arms. Why are you here, my child? I had said goodbye to you, she cried, Baba. One more time, can I sleep in your arms? The Imam hugged her and lay down. After a few minutes, he took Sakina in his arms and asked his sister Zainab, I have to go now. It is nearly the time for Asr. Take special care of my Sakina. The Imam left and rode out alone. Soon it was a time for Asr. After a brave battle, he fell from his horse. He was attacked from all sides. And when Bibi Zainab could not see him anymore, she came out to see. Bibi Sakina followed her aunt. They could not see him. So they returned to the camp and found that the sky was going dark. A terrible wind blew, and the sound of drums could be heard. Hussain has been killed in Karbala. Bibi Sakina saw that her father's horse was running back to the camp. Where is my Baba? She cried. The horse rubbed his head at her feet as if to say, Sakina, your Baba has been killed. You are an orphan. A sound of wailing came from the sky. The ground trembled. The land of Karbala went dark. And the sky wept blood.